I found that Americans have less trouble pronouncing Spiegelman than most of them. So that's a bit perhaps only those from New York. The Google Hall, particularly those from overseas, if I could say that just welcome you on behalf of the legal profession of this state to our city. There's a bit more wind than we're used to, but it's otherwise a congenial weekend for you at this conference. This is an invitation which I've received intrigued me a lot, in the sense that it's not an area that comes across my desk as an active judge. These are not disputes or issues that come before the courts, at least in my jurisdiction. However, it's an area of great significance and importance. I've myself been directly engaged in many activities promoting the development of the administration of justice in this region, particularly in the Pacific to some degree, but in other areas to a greater degree. It was my initiative we established the first exchanges between the judiciaries of Australia and India, and Australia and Japan. The relationship with the Korean judiciary has been a little more difficult to establish, and that is despite the fact that we actually have a treaty of cooperation in legal matters between our two nations. That's an initiative of a former Chief Justice of Korea that was put on the agenda some time ago. It's a document that is now out of date and does require some updating, but it's nevertheless the Korean judges, as other ones, one of the things I established was a conference of serving corporation commercial judges throughout the Asian region. And that is first conference happened 3 years ago in Sydney, the second earlier this year in Hong Kong, the third will happen again in Sydney next year. And judges from throughout the region have come, and it's been a fantastic process of exchange, including, say, the Korean Chief Justice sent delegates to each of the two conferences, and they made a superb contribution, as did significant delegations from most other nations in the region. This is something that judges are doing, in fact, interacting and finding a great deal of mutual encouragement and mutual understanding from the process of such interaction. More and more, issues of a cross-border nature are coming to the courts, including the courts of Australia, and these pose quite difficult questions. But the one thing that is now clear is that there is an international sense of collegiality among judges. And in that respect, the kinds of direct court-to-court communications that are now occurring in matters like cross-border insolvency and freezing injunctions to prevent assets being spirited away from one jurisdiction or another, these do require cooperation between courts, and that's occurring. Now, the area of activity in which you are involved is, of course, multilateral in its origins, and it's something that even the issues don't arise before the formal judiciary to any great degree, then will arise tangentially more and more arguments of that. So I'm very pleased to be here to indicate my support for this issue. May I say, the main reason that I did so is because I have a great interest in any manifestation of what you might call intellectual entrepreneurship. And Professor Lee is quite clearly an intellectual entrepreneur. You wouldn't be here if you didn't have that instinct and capacity. And it's quite clear that he brought together a significant number of scholars of high standing in the field, and I wish the Institute and the